today. The guest is Dr. Leonard Madu, and the topic is Cuba. And Dr. Madu, I think the last time that we spoke in reference to this, we were talking about some of the medical advantages you indicated and as a prelude to talking about some of the problems that Cuba might have. Mm-hmm. But let's say some additional, make some additional statements in reference to medicine in Cuba.
Yeah, like I said, you know, Cuba has one of the best medical, you know, systems in the world today. In terms of AIDS, like we've been talking about, Cuba exports, you know, one of the best HIV/AIDS vaccines to most of the third world countries. In fact, most of the Latin American countries buy their HIV/AIDS vaccines from Cuba. In terms of percentage of those infected by AIDS, Cuba has probably the lowest, you know, in the whole world. When this HIV/AIDS came to Cuba, Fidel Castro, you know, quarantined the first those who were identified initially, you know, to the island of Pines. You know, they were quarantined. Then he made sure everybody had to be tested and checked out. And then they moved there and started manufacturing, you know, HIV/AIDS vaccines. So that today, countries like Venezuela, Bolivia, you name it, Mozambique, Angola, a lot of them import their HIV/AIDS vaccines from Cuba. You know, in terms of eyesight, Cuba has one of the best. As we speak right now, there are thousands of people from a lot of South American countries sitting in Havana waiting for their eyesight to be corrected. Some, you know, glaucoma and all this. Yes, Cuba has one of the best. So in terms of medicine, they have, you know, achieved a very, very, you know, very big, big feat in that country. We don't hear much about it.
Not at all. Yeah. No, we don't hear anything about it, as a matter of fact.
When President Carter went to Cuba, you know, he was amazed when he went to the Biotechnology Institute to see what they are doing. So in terms of healthcare system, the Cuban Revolution has accomplished a lot. They are in educational facilities, probably one of the best in South America. You know, education is free in Cuba, you know, from elementary to university. So they have probably the highest literacy rate in the Western Hemisphere, even higher than ours here. Yeah, about 99%.
That's 99, extraordinary.
Yeah, about 99.9% literacy rate in Cuba. So that's a Gangatuan accomplishment. Now, what are the failures, you know, of the Cuban Revolution? We can say, you know, human rights. In countries, you know, that dictatorships like Cuba is, you know, people don't have the right to say what they want to say. They don't have the right to publish what they want to. You know, a lot of the newspapers, radio are controlled by the government. You know, the largest newspaper, you know, Granma, is communist, you know, controlled. People don't have a right to go to wherever they want to, when they want to. You know, you can't just say, well, I'm going to the airport, Havana airport, I'm going to the United States. No, you can't just, you know, the government won't allow you to do that. They want to make sure where you're going to and give you a pass to go and come back, you know. So some of those things are the human rights situation. Jobs, you can just get up, say, well, I want to go and change my job. I got to be working at TSU, no more at Fisk. You can't do that. The government controls the economy.
Okay.
About 95, 96, 97% of the economy is government controlled. And that's where we come to one of the most important earth-shattering, you know, news about Cuba. When Fidel got sick, you know, he handed over to his brother and a group of those around him, you know, officially. Raul took over on February 8, you know, last year as president of Cuba. What has happened since then is that they started looking at the economic downturn in the world. And they say, well, no. We have 5.1 million employees in Cuba. That's the government workforce, 5.1. Raul and his advisors say, no, we can't keep this up. You know, there are a lot of people just sitting, eating, not doing anything, but we are paying
just
them.
Just part of the government
payroll.
Yeah,
the government payroll. This is too much. You know, if we have to survive,